What's going on, Homeless Minor Legion? This is footage from the live stream I did with Tyler Beatty over on Facebook Live. I do a live show called Homeless Minor Leaguer Live every Monday at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Welcome to Homeless Minor Leaguer Live. I am here joined with Tyler Beatty, number one Giants prospect, but more importantly, my former road roommate.
It was an absolute honor to be a road roommate with you, and it's an absolute honor to join you tonight live in your incredible spot for minor league baseball, which is, I'm sure, going to be explained.
Yeah, so this is what we're sitting in right now. Is we're actually sitting on my bed, which it pulls out. It's a futon. It pulls out. It's a great setup. If you guys watch my vlogs, you guys can go check it out over there. I'm looking at the comments. I got the comments right here, you guys. So, comment away. So, before we get started, I want to talk about the live auction that we have going on in the comments. So, you guys can message in the comments. The we are auctioning off. You want to say it? Yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to auction off a bunch of stuff, but we got... A signed Sal League Baseball.
A signed South Atlantic League Baseball, which, if you know, Tyler didn't play in the South Atlantic League, so that is a one-of-a-kind item.
Very one-of-a-kind.
Yeah, what else are we auctioning off?
I have cleats. I got an old glove.
Oh, my god!
This stuff isn't here with me, but use your imagination. You can imagine what these cleats look like. They're game-worn. I got a little used to them, but... It's a one-time thing, so this is going to be pretty special.
Yeah.
Gabe Alvarez maybe wins, maybe doesn't.
Gabe Alvarez.
We'll see.
Oh, he's in the chat
right
now.
He's a fan favorite right now at top of the list, but it doesn't come down to fan favorites.
Oh, my gosh.
It comes down to who interacts the most with us.
Yeah, so who's got some questions right now? So you guys start commenting your questions, but mainly what I want to talk about is right now is your rapping. So what did you just drop recently? You just dropped a track, right?
I dropped my first single ever. It's called Top of the World. You can find it on Spotify. If you just search my name, Tyler Beatty, Top of the World, you'll find it. It features my buddy Sam James from back home. He was on The Voice. Features a buddy who also plays for the Cubs and is a rapper as well. His name's John Williamson. It's called Swilson. So go check it out. You can play it. Maybe we'll play it here for you guys a little bit.
Ooh, yeah. We got it right here. We'll play it. What else do you have cooking up for a song right now? What's your next single you got cooking up?
So I'm not sure if people have been paying attention to the Twitter, but Smash Mouth, for some reason, reached out to me.
That's right.
Wanting to do a collaboration. And so I've been in talks with Smash Mouth, which is crazy to even say. And they've sent me a song that's been unreleased. For me to write on and record in the studio. So we'll keep that under wraps.
Yeah.
But for you guys who have been lucky enough and blessed us with watching us tonight, you got that inside information. Maybe I'll play a little tidbit for you guys, but
Ooh.
Not too much.
Ooh.
It's really cool. It's like a pump-up baseball song, walk-out type of song. So if you guys need one, stay tuned for that Smash Mouth hit coming with us.
Let's go. Hey, now you're an all-star, Sandra says. Gabe Alvarez says, I'm just here for the free hip-hop. I love it. I love it. What did you guys do in the off season? So what did you do in the off season? What was your off season like? You got engaged.
I got engaged. I say that tops the list of things that I did this off season. I got engaged. She's probably not watching. She's watching The Bachelor somewhere, I'm sure.
Oh.
So, but I do. I love you, Allie, if you're watching. I got engaged. I traveled a little bit. Went to Hawaii. We took a cruise for 7 days. Went to Puerto Rico, the Dominican, St. Thomas, and Turks and Caicos. So we were blessed
busy,
with some travel, man. We were busy. I just bought a house, too, in Texas, so it was a busy offseason.
In Houston, right?
In Houston, man.
Dude, I drove through Houston this offseason.
You did. Yeah. Phenomenal place.
But, like, you weren't there yet. You weren't there yet. Yeah. I would have hit you up, though.
Yes.
Let me look at the comments right now. During the offseason, do you stop baseball training completely, or do you modify baseball training?
I'd pretty much start baseball training right away. You?
Yeah, it's... I mean, I guess even the recovery process counts as baseball training.
Yeah.
Right? So I normally take a few weeks off right when the season ends.
Oh, absolutely.
And then get back into it, but you slowly progress. You're not starting off right away throwing, right? You're
right.
Not even playing catch to start off. So
yeah. No,
when do you normally start playing catch?
Yeah, no, like, baseball work for really any position player or pitcher until, like, beginning December, middle of December.
Yeah, that's
when I start throwing, and I know a lot of guys do that. But we're in the weight room, and we're conditioning getting our bodies recovered and for the next season a couple weeks after the into the off season. So
yeah,
we're in the weight room almost every day.
Yeah. What type of exercise works best in the off season to get you back into shape?
Yeah, so it's a way to phrase that question, because back into shape is well said, because we do get kind of out of shape through our season. Dumpy, you can probably go back and watch Matt's video called...
Oh my gosh, Bad Bods.
If you guys haven't seen it,
go check out Bad Bods.
Go check out Bad Bods.
It's over on my sketch comedy channel, Homeless Minor Leaguer, over on YouTube. Yeah, so if there was one exercise that Eric Cressy, if he was watching, would say, that's what you have to do, what exercise would that be?
He would torture.
I think I know which one it is.
Torturously tell me kettlebell, Turkish get-ups, and probably just cardio, dude.
Isn't he a big deadlift fan though?
Deadlifts, yes.
Deadlifts,
sumo deadlifts, trap bar deadlifts, regular deadlifts.
Gotta get your deadlifts in.
The guy can deadlift 600 pounds. I'm sure he's watching.
Brian Regira just joined.
Wow, rags.
If Brian Regira, great guy, we miss you. Yoneshwi Fargus, two of our teammates. What was your worst skill as a little leaguer?
My worst skill as a little leaguer? Probably my temper tantrum. just throwing fits on the mound, man. If guys weren't making plays behind me, I might have thrown a glove.
Oh my gosh.
But that was probably it.
That one came from Sarah, that question. My worst skill was when I was 9 years old. I did not swing the bat one time the whole season.
Just taking pitches?
I took pitches. Yeah, the whole season. I didn't swing once.
Wow. Just practicing your patience at the plate?
Yeah, exactly. Wow. Yeah. Yeah, I was working to be an on-base percentage machine.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's phenomenal.
Let's see. Any minor league rivalries, former teammates, or teams?
Minor league rivalries. We play the Rockies almost every level.
Yes.
So, I mean, from... Mm-hmm. Did we play them in the Sal League?
Yes.
Sal
they're
League.
They're in Asheville. It's every
Eastern
level.
League, PCL.
Right? Because it's... I haven't played in Salem, but do you play them in Salem too?
Ooh. I don't know. I don't really remember.
It's basically every level, because triple A, double A, high A, low A. So, yeah, you got everything, and rookie ball too. So
you start to face those guys like so frequently throughout your career, and then you see them in the big leagues. For those guys up there, and you start to see familiar guys, and you want to get them out, especially if they've gotten you in.
Make sure you are bidding on the South Atlantic League, Tyler Beattie signed baseball, and various other things too, because why not? It's a one-of-a-kind item, South Atlantic League signed ball by Tyler Beattie. Can't get it anywhere else. Let's see. Just working on your eye. It's fine. Yes. Yeah. Exactly what I was doing. Do you get nervous playing with Posey? Congrats on your engagement. That comes from...
Thank you, Jasmine. I got nervous last year. So there was a situation where all first-year guys, he always wants to catch them. So, like, we're walking to the bullpen mounds, a group of us pitchers, and Posey's sitting there behind the plate. And as I'm walking to the mound, I want to go towards a uncomfortable throwing with a guy who I've thrown with before. And Posey just goes, Beattie, you're on my mound. We're throwing together. And that's when your heart starts just racing, beating out of your chest. I was pretty nervous. And this year I got to throw to him again, and just a little bit more comfortable. He's an easy guy to be comfortable around. He's really personable and such a great catcher. So thank you on the engagement. Congratulations. Yes, I appreciate that. And appreciate it. Good question.
Okay, so Gabe corrected me in the comments, said, we don't play the Rockies in the AZL, but he said that's the only place. We do play them in Salem, I guess. How do we bid for it? Just comment. Just write in the comments. Just bid. What is the bidding going to start at for that ball? Let's start it at $5. We'll start it right there.
$5. We'll donate it to...
Yes.
I have a nonprofit foundation called
Yes.
More Than Me. We give back to the local communities, athletes who are passionate about giving back. We give back to the local community, so we'll put it towards that.
Donate it. Yeah, I didn't specify that, but we will be donating it. How do you like pitching at the Diamond?
That's in Richmond.
Oh, see, I haven't been to Richmond yet.
Ray Edwards. Love pitching.
Oh,
at the
I met Ray. Ray is a great guy.
Ray, phenomenal guy. Phenomenal ballpark at the Diamond. It's big, so pitchers like me, we love it. You can give up an absolute tank fly ball, but it stays in the park. So any stadium like that. We love Bray may not, but his power can definitely overtake any big stadium. So I think he'll be all right there.
We got bids on the the ball.
Your mom?
My mom and your dad are bidding against 25. Each other right now.
28.
Oh, we got 28. Okay. Oh gosh, I lost the comments for a second. Who else has some questions? Let me scroll up. Let me see if I miss any questions. What do you learn from Cueto or Bumgarner, or just and Bumgarner? Like, let's just make it an and.
I learn a ton. The biggest thing from Bumgarner, I think, is easy to tell when he pitches, is how convicted he is in his stuff. I mean, a guy who, you know, he has premier stuff. He's a big leader. He has big league stuff. But I think the separator for guys like that is how convicted you are in your stuff and how pinpoint he is with the what we call as the quadrants of the zone. So you got down and away, down and in, up and in, and up and away. And the guy is methodical with how well he can hit those corners. And
are we good right now? It looks like we're lagging. How are we, Lisa? Are we good?
What do you mean?
Looks like we're lagging on here. Oh, no. It came back.
So, yeah, so we were just having some technical difficulties, but we're back.
Yes,
so I learned a lot from those guys. Cueto, he's deceptive. What he does with his body and his mechanics, he speeds up hitters, slows them down with his body and with his pitch speed and selection. So you just learn a lot from watching them and then interacting with them. They have so much wisdom and knowledge in the game that it's easy to learn from them.
So, wow, we got Susan just
75.
Mom, you can't bid $30 when someone just bid 75. $1. All right, this one's for both of us. Favorite rest? Oh, no, hold on. Miss Brett K's. I'm going to come back to that one.
Oh, Brett.
Brett K. Brett K, former teammate. He's a longtime listener, as in last week he came in to listen probably. First time caller. What's your favorite spring training spread? Heard the powdered eggs are phenomenal. The spread at spring training, just in general, the Giants do a great job of taking care of us when it comes to food.
Yes.
Last season was the first year where they started catering Whole Foods before games and after games. That was clutch. I don't know what it was like for you.
Yeah, same thing. Yeah, I think you know it's top of the line when you have the chefs are called sports performance chefs. I mean, I think that's just taking the game to the next level.
Yeah.
So they do a great job of feeding us well.
Yeah.
My favorite spreads. Man, we had like lasagna the other day.
Lasagna?
For lunch, man. That was on fire.
Oh, gosh.
I'm Italian, so
Let's see. I miss the restaurants. Favorite restaurants in Arizona?
So many. I just learned this one. It's in Arcadia. It's called The Stand. It's a burger joint. Really good. I think it's better than In-N-Out, which is like a bold statement.
You know what? Here's my theory on In-N-Out. And oh, so this? No. We were together. Remember when we were at the in San Jose? We went to with Allie.
Yeah.
We went to read to
yes.
an elementary school.
Yes.
Okay, guys. So we went to go read to an elementary school back in 2015.
Yep.
And it was for an appearance, and the kids had just. I'm convinced that the kids are brainwashed in California to believe this is a conspiracy to believe that In-N-Out is the best burger joint because they go on field trips there when they're young.
Wow.
And remember, they were all wearing the hats when
yes,
they showed up.
I do remember.
They were all wearing the In-N-Out hats.
Yep.
I think that it's great marketing on the part of In-N-Out.
Absolutely.
So, yeah.
So basically, I agree with them 100%. In-N-Out's made me sick multiple times. So I'm totally dissing In-N-Out, but The Stand, phenomenal.
That might get you in bad blood with the San Francisco fans.
I love In-N-Out. I mean, I'm a huge supporter. But The Stand, as of right now, is one of my favorites.
The Stand
here in Arizona.
What about Chop Shop? Chop Shop's my favorite spot.
Chop Shop used to be like top of the list, and then they built a place next door called Farm and Craft.
Let me tell you,
it's one upped.
Really?
Chop Shop.
Do you think it's owned by the same people?
So I went over there and I asked them. They said, no. It's phenomenal.
Oh, my god!
Healthy
gosh.
Food, healthy
That's
living.
That's like Instagram throwing up Instagram stories right in Snapchat's face.
Yes.
It's the same exact thing.
This is exactly what So you got to try both if you're in Arizona. My dad is going to be disappointed to hear Chop Shop is not the best anymore because he is like diehard. Like
really?
He dreams about Chop Shop.
Guys, just want to thank you really quick for liking, loving it, and sharing this with your friends. That means a lot. And remember that you can bid on the Tyler Beatty signed South Atlantic League baseball. He didn't even play in the South Atlantic League, so it's a one of a kind.
One of a kind.
Let's see. Let me read some of the comments. How do you feel about the same playlist for BP every day? Yeah, that one comes from Tay. Yeah, that is kind of a thing, isn't it? Like, that it can kind of get repetitive. But I think it's way worse when the music just isn't on. Like, sometimes, like...
Oh, yeah.
That's when you go to a visiting place and they just forget to turn it on for you because you're the visitors and they don't care.
Exactly.
Yeah, would you agree with that?
I'd agree. I say it goes hand in hand with sharing the national anthem before every single game.
Oh.
It gets a little repetitive, but
yeah,
sometimes it's necessary. So
yes.
We prefer music over no music.
Yeah. How are we over on Periscope? Are we on Periscope right now?
Yeah,
fine.
You had 25, but now you're down to 12.
Oh my gosh, there's people watching the Periscope right now? Hey, people are watching Periscope.
16.
Hey, people who are watching Periscope, go over to Facebook. Anyway, let's see. This one comes from Robert James. Any funny or embarrassing moments while playing?
Oh, plenty of embarrassing ones. I mean, I've dropped plenty of PFP throws to me at first base. The funny? Oh, gosh. There have been some... Do you remember that game in San Jose where we're playing the Angels? Where is that one at? In high A?
Not Inland Empire.
Yeah.
Is it?
Is it Inland Empire?
I think it is Inland Empire.
Inland Empire. We're up like 4-0 and I pitch the game and then Ian Gardick comes in and the bases end up being loaded, right? And Ian throws like a 99 mile an hour sinker, breaks this guy's bat, it goes down the third baseline. It was foul. He rules it fair. And then it goes into so their bullpen is on the field, so their bench is on the field. The ball goes under their bullpen, right? So it's like ground rule double. Our outfielder should not go for it, and the umpire should basically rule the ball dead. The umpire doesn't rule the ball dead, and our left fielder, Jesus Galindo, decides to go and pick up the ball. So that means that the ball is still in play.
I remember this.
It ended up being an inside the park, broken bat, grand slam.
Oh my
we ended
gosh.
Up losing the game.
Oh, wait, no, I wasn't there. I was in Augusta at the time.
You were?
Sure. Yeah, I'm pretty sure
so
I was in
it
Augusta.
It was unbelievable. It wasn't funny, but it was crazy. That's a crazy story.
Your dad's upset that it's better than In-N-Out.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, Dad. Come on out, though. Come and visit.
Yes, yes. Mom, can you come visit too? let's see. Did I miss one up here? No. Sarah, what's your favorite sport to watch in the off season?
I love football, man. Big
go
fantasy.
Pats.
Go Pats, yes.
Go Pats, kid.
Tom Brady's probably watching this, so shout out to Tom.
Yeah.
I love you. He's probably watching.
Yeah.
But football, yeah, I'm a big fantasy football guy, so it's usually heartbreaking for me because I always lose. But I love watching football, too.
Let's see.
Matt?
Who is your favorite? Holly asks, who is your favorite baseball player?
Mine's Matt Pare.
Oh,
personally, just an easy connection there when I watch a sweet swing from the left side of the plate.
Stop it. Well, now, I mean, mine's Tyler Beatty, you know?
Thank you.
Yeah, he's got that live arm that, you know, gosh.
Live arm.
It's electric.
It's not too live right now.
Yeah, it's live. You're right here. It's live.
Oh,
your arm's
live.
Oh.
We're auctioning off the arm
yes.
as well.
Yeah. Bidding starts at
$5. We'll say
$5. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Very reasonable. Remember, go bid in the comments $50 for the cleats. We got $50 for the cleats, it looks like. Where are we at right now? Matt, why does it always rain in LA whenever you try to record a sketch? I don't know. It does always happen though. It's always raining in LA whenever I want it. That one was from Stephanie. Chris, did you guys ever face each other before the Giants? No, we didn't. So I went to Boston College.
Yep.
Tyler went to Vanderbilt.
And we never played each other.
No,
I wish
never
we did.
Played each other.
And we
he
never
carved me out.
Never had live BPs against each other.
Not yet. No, we haven't. I've only caught you. That's it.
But yeah.
I don't ever think. Have I ever? I've caught you in spring training, and that's it. I've never caught you in a game during the season.
This is something that we're gonna have to visualize and make happen.
Yeah, so. Just so like maybe we'll do a sketch or something like that, and then, like, that's the only way we'd be able to do it.
We could just carry this live chat into the early hours of the morning and just throw to each other
when
the sun comes out.
Yeah, well, no, you're not allowed to do that.
Oh, we'll wait till next year.
Yeah.
Early, later in the year.
Let's see. Tyler, New England clam chowder and lobster rolls. I'm assuming that's clam cakes or rib steak type of guy.
Oh, I'm a chowder guy.
Chowder
for sure.
Kid.
Oh, wicked. Wicked all over the lobster rolls. We played in Portland last year, and I got mac and cheese.
You know I grew up in Portland, right?
You did?
Yeah, I used to be the bullpen catcher for the Sea Dogs back
Let's
in high
go.
School. We used to be a host family.
Yes,
for the Sea
I knew
Dogs.
That. Okay, I knew that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Phenomenal.
But you got lobster rolls down in the old port.
Lobster rolls.
I bet there's some people from Portland watching this live stream right now, too.
Oh, yeah? A couple of Maine guys?
Yes, up, down, north, yep, Maine, yes, up, down,
oh,
east,
yeah.
Up.
Don't forget where you packed you
I-95, off Turnpike, yes, up. let's see. Okay. No shot. Gabe is heated right now.
Yes, I love this.
No shot. Farm and Craft is below Chop Shop. Farm and Craft is owned by the guys of El Jefe and Whiskey Row. Okay, that makes sense. They're like kind of dominating over there.
So he's just mad that they're kind of taking over everything.
And your dad, too. He's getting in on it, too.
Wait till he has it. He hasn't tried it yet.
I think they're drinking the Kool-Aid just like, like In-N-Out.
They are. They're basically on the same bandwagon.
How much for the cleats? Well, you can bid in the comments for the cleats, for the ball, for the, what's the other one? The cleats.
We got an old glove as well.
And an old glove. You can bid for those. The money is going towards Tyler's charity.
Yes. Ooh, Allie has joined.
Allie's
the fiance is in.
Oh, hello, hello. I remember that. I wish I remembered it. I wasn't there. You missed questions? Mom, what did I miss? Mom, I can't scroll up. Who's the best fiance ever? Oh.
That's an easy one, Allie DeBerry. Soon to be Allie DeBerry Beattie.
Da Beattie.
The Beattie.
Da Beattie.
We've dubbed ourselves.
Yes.
Ew.
Tommy is the GOAT. The greatest of all time. Let's see.
200 for your UCL.
That's really good. Okay, $70 for the cleats. Okay. $20 for the glove. $40 for the glove. Ooh. Tyler, you don't have a masshole accent, bud.
Oh, yeah, Chris.
Lobster
You're
with the
right.
butter.
I tried to blend in.
Danielle. What did I miss? I didn't miss anything. Right? All right, we're good now.
This is probably easy to guess. So I went to Vanderbilt, and then we won the College World Series in 2014. That was pretty sweet.
Yeah. All right, we're back. What did I miss? Yeah, so Susie, to answer your question, I am not answering that question. That is a trap question. And every host family that I've stayed with is amazing. Okay. So, we've got people bidding on the glove, we got people bidding on the ball, we got people bidding on the cleats. I think the ball is going to be like, it's a South Atlantic League ball. No one has a signed South Atlantic League ball by Tyler Beattie.
Correct.
Just saying. This
if
is
you guys
a bit
have
choppy.
Any, have any other things that you would like us to auction off? We're up for ideas.
Yeah.
Maybe we can pull it up.
Hey,
yeah.
This is your most viewed live video. Yet, so
this
congratulations.
Is, oh my gosh.
This is amazing.
Guys.
What an honor.
Oh, yeah.
And,
two. Okay, better now it says. All right, cool. Yeah,
Dane,
it does look a lot better.
Dane, I'm going to answer your question. If my dad wins the bid, will I make him pay for it? Yes, absolutely. and to be fair, he may not be even available to win these because, you know what, I'm not even going to give him that option.
Oh, Giants BP jacket, your dad says.
We can auction up a Giants BP jacket.
Ooh,
we can throw that in there.
Let's go.
Yep.
Bidding starts at $5.
Bidding starts at $5, yes.
Always. Glad to see you're doing well. Keep up the good work, man.
Thank you, Robbie. Yes. hope all is well with you and the family. Tell them I say hello.
Let's see. Who else has questions? I think we're a little behind because people are... Oh, look at these. Throwing out the likes. Showering us with likes. We love you guys. 150 for the BP jacket.
150?
150.
Big Walt setting the tone.
Unless he's bidding on something else. $5.01. Jalen Miller.
Jalen. My dog.
We'll see you at spring training soon. Look at this. You know what I love about this live stream? Is that we've got fans, but we've also got players in the live stream joining the chat. We're just all hanging out together. Dude, so cool.
Hey, we're baseball players, but we're just human beings, man. We just like having fun.
Yeah.
We're like interacting with you guys.
Look at this. Jalen says, he beat me. Yeah, but you got all the same digits, though. He just rearranged your digits.
He did. You're correct.
Yeah.
Let's just remove my dad's offer. We'll keep it. We'll start it at $5. Hey, Walt, we're not doing 150. That's too big of a jump. That's like throwing an ace on a three to start a card game. I mean, we got to let the players play here.
You all look like you should be on Minecraft. Oh, because it's so choppy. She's saying it's because the feed's so choppy. We look like the block characters.
Oh.
I'm sorry. The Wi-Fi's pretty good here. I just added a router over there, or a little like hotspot. How's the hotspot over there? Yeah. Okay.
It's blinking green. That's
okay. Yeah. That's perfect. Yeah. Yeah. It looks good. $50 for the jacket.
Ooh.
Okay.
Sandra. Patron.
Wow. You never know who will show up to Homeless Minor Leaguer Live. Free marketing. Shade. Throwing shade. My brother. That's my brother. Frank East said throwing shade. We retweet the Periscope live feed just so...
Yeah.
And also tweet the link out to the Homeless Minor Leaguer one. The quality is fine now. Okay, cool.
Thanks, Frankie.
Frankie. $60 for the jacket.
From Dane Wheel.
Oh, my gosh.
Phenomenal.
Wow. Am I missing any comments right now?
So just to remind everyone, we got a jacket. We got a SAL League Baseball, South Atlantic League Baseball. We got cleats. We got a glove. And what am I missing? Hey, that's it.
Ball, cleats, glove,
jacket.
Yep. Boom. All being auctioned off, donated to charity.
More than
$70
charity.
For the jacket. Yep. As a parent, I would buy all my son's stuff, too. I get it. Yeah. All right. Who has questions? Who has some more questions? Let me scroll up. Let me see. But let's see here. How long have we been going live for? We're 30 minutes in. This is awesome. We still got a nice audience going right now.
So let me ask a question to the viewers here. If you guys like hip-hop, or if you don't, let us know. And we could potentially scheme up a instrumental beat, and I can freestyle for you guys based on comments, so I can read through and freestyle.
Let's do a freestyle.
You guys can give me topics.
Oh my gosh.
It may be good, it may not, but hey, we're here to have a good time.
Yes, let's do that. Okay, hold on. Let's answer. Well, okay, what's the charity? Yeah, so say the charity one more time.
Yeah, so you guys were here earlier. So it's the More Than Me Foundation. It was started about 6 years ago. We assist athletes in giving back to the local community. So for Matt and I, growing up in the Northeast, we like to appreciate where we came from, the people who helped us got it there, and just really repay those communities with our time, with our money and efforts. And as of right now, we're working in the Nashville community to build a Miracle League field for the children there at the Miracle League. Money will go directly to that as of right now.
Exactly. Strangest thing either of you has autographed? I don't know. I can't think of that. What, have you autographed anything strange?
Nothing crazy. Phones. People wanted me to sign their phones. I think that's kind
of
strange.
You know what really gets me is the white pieces of paper. I never sign those.
Whatever. Yeah, I'm not into stealing identities.
Yeah. That's not cool. I don't know if it got answered, but... Where the heck are those porcelain hands from?
Did you see that?
Wife? No.
So we have these in our house for spring training. We have these, like, it's a book holders. You know those book holder things?
Yeah,
and
they're
porcelain hands, bookends. Correct. And we have literally just been, as you can imagine, we've just been, like, getting creative with, like, what those hands could be used for. And we're posting them on our Instagram stories and stuff like that.
Oh, my gosh.
So what was the question? Where did we get them from?
Yeah, they're just from
They came with the house. The house was furnished and they were in there. We've been having a good old time.
Let's get the freestyle going. You have your phone. You want to throw up the music?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, let's see. Throw up anybody a have beat. A beat suggestion?
Who's got, all right. Who's got a beat? Do you guys have a beat suggestion?
Kind of dark and ominous.
Yeah.
Grab something from
me. Share the video.
Okay. So you guys can hear it.
Yes, but it's coming. It's
so
coming because...
Give us some comments. Hey, we're here live with my man Matt Parade. This a freestyle, not sure what I will say. So I'll read from the comment section and hear a thing or two. Yeah, I'm reading everything you gotta say too. Okay, let's start off with what... let's start off with pitching that AT&T. Yeah, you know the initials is T and B. Okay, be a genie in a bottle. I got a new whip, a Beamer, and I'm full throttle. Yeah, you know, I love food, baseball, yeah. Okay, everything I do is for y'all. Okay, what else we got? Favorite burger, it's the stand. Yeah, you know, my man Matt Parade, he's really the man. So, what else we got? Okay, me and my fiance, it happened up on Twitter. Yeah, the social media game was on point, I can't hit it. Oh. Yeah, you know, gotta... Keep it smooth. Me and Allie going strong for 3 years. That's cool. Okay. Can't wait for the wedding day up in November. Yeah. You know me. It's gonna be one to remember. Oh. Pitch mixes. I got that heater in the curve. Yeah, you know. I don't really like to slur my words. But what else we got? Okay. Nobody else has anything to say. So I'll just keep rapping what comes up on my mind. You know. All this live stuff is really fine, okay.
Oh, man.
What else we got? Come on. Bring the comments.
Comments are lagging right now.
Klein's comments on Visit the Man. Oh, my mom's joined in. What's up, Mama Riff? Yeah, you know, all my lyrics is really sick. Okay, hiking in Arizona. We got Camelback. Yeah, you know, every time I'm on it, they try to hand me that. I'm like, please, don't. What? I don't know where I'm stepping. Favorite TV shows. Lately, I've been into Stranger Things.
Oh.
So, I don't know what you gotta say to that, because I can't sing, so I'll just keep rapping. This is so hard. What's about your dad bidding on your dad?
Oh my gosh. In-N-Out.
What about? Rap about In-N-Out?
In-N-Out, yeah.
So, I choose to stand over In-N-Out. Don't really listen to these lyrics that I'm spitting out. But all of a sudden, I'm thinking about burgers. So I'll probably drive home tonight and get a couple burgers. So I'm a little dumpy right now. But I'll keep rapping to my fans right now. My dad's really bidding high. Dad, you gotta bid a little lower, guy. Okay, how about B-Craw? They made me rap the other day, him and D-Law. I was rapping in the clubhouse. It was him, Bochy. All of a sudden, these people know me. I'm like, okay, this is cool. I'm rapping about my man, Jimmy Rollins. He's like, man, you gotta keep it calling. You gotta keep it coming. Keep the raps flowing. I'm like, I'll keep going long as you keep growing. He's like, I won the MVP. Back in the day, I was running and scoring bases like every other day. So... About my teammates, yeah. They are the best. Yeah, you know we all got that G-I-A-N-T-S across the chest. Oh. Bubble gum, yeah, bubble gum. All of a sudden, I got it in my mouth, yum. Mic drop. I'll keep rapping, though. Rap about vegan food, that's not for me, bro. Arizona weather, usually it's hot. But this time around, it's cold and the beaches drop. So I'll just kick it a cappella. You know me and Matt Parade, we live right now. Keep tuning in, fellas.
Oh, wow. That was amazing. Wow. Bravo.
Thank you guys for the comments. I appreciate it. Thank
bravo.
You. Thank you.
That was awesome. Wow. I'm so impressed right now. Who else has some questions right
now?
Yeah,
let's hear some questions.
Remember, I'm sweating right now just from that. Like, I can't imagine you. I'm sweating. That was amazing. Who's got some questions? Yeah, my mom says, great job. Clap, clap, clap. Give me standing out in my living room.
Well, thank you.
When did you start rapping?
I went to prep school my junior and senior year of high school, and so I lived there. And there were a lot of international students from Korea, from all over the world, and a lot of Korean students had been making beats and when I couldn't sleep because it was going through the wall, I decided to go in there and they needed a guinea pig to rap on the beats, and I was terrible, awful. But I started to get a little bit better from there, and it started back in junior year of high school, and it's come to this.
Oh my gosh. When did you pitch last, or when do you pitch next? You pitched yesterday. You pitched well, right?
I pitched yesterday, yep. Pitched at the Reds' place. Two quality innings. I'll take it.
That
place
is far, man, right?
It was like an hour drive. Yeah, Goodyear. I don't know when I'll pitch. You never know. I'm thinking Thursday or Friday. Hopefully in front of the hometown fans.
My house is full of ants. This one comes from Sarah. Have you ever had a bug invasion while on the road or at a stadium?
Oh.
Have you? Has there been like a breakout of bed bugs?
No, not bed bugs, but there was this one time. It was actually at the College World Series. My buddy and I were just sitting in the room, and we heard like a cricket chirping, and we were wondering like how the heck, because we're like whatever floors up in a hotel, and we like turn off the TV and we're like investigating where this is coming from. We're like thinking it's come from behind the bed, under the bed, pillows. Come to find out, it was in his this cricket or whatever had crawled into his catcher's mitt. And we finally heard it, and so we're like, oh my god, what the heck is in there? And we knock it out, and then this thing starts jumping all around, and it jumps behind the TV, and we're trying to kill it. And this is like an hour ordeal trying to like get this thing, because it would have just kept
like the
going
bug we just killed in here.
Yes, it's a living, I think.
Oh yeah, no, yeah, you saved the bug. You didn't have to kill it. This guy didn't want to kill the bug. He was like, no, we got it. Put it right outside. He just waved it like magically. It just went outside. I had something this past season though. Adam Sonnabend and I, we were road roommates. Our hotel room was infested with ants. And they were just all marching around the place. No. We had no idea. Yeah, so we had to switch rooms.
Gosh.
Yeah.
Adam Sonnabend, what a guy.
What a guy. Great.
Is he even listening?
Great guy. I'm sure he's probably doing something productive.
Yeah. He's like, a productive guy. Yeah. He's probably reading.
It worked. Like he's always on his computer doing work, something, reading, guy. Like listening to a podcast. That guy, an amazing guy. Which pitcher are you looking forward to the least? Which pitcher?
For you?
This
question is directed at you.
No, they're asking you in the batter's box as a pitcher. Who are you
least looking forward to facing? Someone who just brings the noise, but like doesn't know where it's going. Like,
oh, that's I got him in the dome this year. This past year, yeah.
So did I.
Did you really?
Yeah, Lucas Giolito.
Oh my gosh, I don't know the name of my guy, but he came in like a blowout situation, left, and I knew before I got there, I'm like, this is gonna be bad.
Yes.
And first pitch, right there.
Oh gosh.
Yeah, I went down. But I'm better.
He's better.
And I learned from it. And I was actually like afraid to get into the box again on left, and it didn't happen for like two more weeks. But I hit a bomb the next left.
Let's go.
So like no big deal.
Hit by pitch record at Boston College. Ooh, this guy's a legend.
Yeah, I hold the hit by pitch record. So lefties aren't huge fans of facing me.
This guy crowds the plate.
Yeah,
that's what he's trying to say.
Yes. Who are your music influences?
I love J. Cole. Being a Christian, I love Lecrae, Trip Lee, those types of artists. I love guys who are lyricists, guys who can really tell a story with your lyrics.
Do you like MF Doom?
Who's that?
It's just like an underground, like he's big.
I don't,
like,
but I will listen.
Okay, so Vox actually has like a really good series all about rapping. I'll show it to you after this.
Yes.
Don't leave this. Yeah. Do you hear that on the roof? It's weird. I heard it last night too. It scared the shh.
It may be. Yeah. They don't have possums here, or do they?
It might be something.
It's a mountain lion.
Yes, mountain lion.
It's scary. It's like on the roof. I heard it last night and I was freaked out. What were we talking about? Oh, Vox. So Vox has a series of videos all about dissecting hip hop and lyrics. So one of the videos was all about Grey Poupon.
Okay.
And rapping, like rappers use Grey Poupon all the time in their songs.
Really?
Yes. Yeah.
They should have used that.
Because it rhymes with a lot of weird words like coupon. And that's all I can think of right now.
Groupon.
Yeah. It's a different word to rhyme with. It sounds cool, but I forget her name. She does a whole series of videos about hip hop. Really good. Let's see what we got. Have you seen a scorpion yet this year? Have you?
Negative.
No, I haven't either, Ma. She's like worried about me. That's why she's asking. Have you seen a scorpion yet? answered that one. Geo, the Banner Barn Grill.
I feel like I've heard of it, but I'm not sure.
Strangest minor league city / stadium. That one comes from Audrey.
What do we got to go with? High Desert?
Adelanto, man. Yeah, High Desert. That's a strange place. You stay like the strange. Motel 6 there.
Yeah, that's a tough one. They've gotten rid of it.
Yeah.
So it's basically...
R.I.P. Adelanto. High Desert Mavericks.
Thank you.
Yeah. No one likes pitching there. That's for sure.
No.
I don't even know if the hitters like playing there, to be honest. Like, they weren't real big
fans. The fans don't like being there.
Even the city didn't like the team being there, you know?
Exactly.
Once a squirrel, always a squirrel. Shout out from Richmond, from Courtney. Favorite genre of music?
Rap, hip-hop?
Yeah, that's... Yeah. Can you rake like Mad Bum?
I don't have quite the pop, but I can swing it. I can swing
it.
I can hold my own.
I believe that.
I'll be confident in that.
Adam was great when he was in Richmond. Yeah, yes. Adam Sonneben. Great guy. It was for you. See? For Tyler. That was
all right, Billy. All right.
What music do you listen to pump you up for a game? Coming from Millie.
Honestly, I just watch Matt Pare's videos like on repeat. So like I really just go through the series.
Oh wow.
That's kind of my
sketches,
yeah.
Yeah.
Bad Bods.
That one will get you ready for the season. Like, we actually have something cooking up right now, a little video, a little sequel to Bad Bods.
Yes.
We're working on something right now. We're cooking something up. So be on the lookout for that sketch. Yeah, it's going to be a parody music video. Let's see what else we got. How's the feed? Are we good?
Mm-hmm.
Periscope feed, good? Yeah. Guys, remember...
Coming in. The stud.
So let's plug the... because it looks like people forgot in the comments after your amazing freestyle and also answering the questions that you can bid on the live auction items. Excuse me.
Yes.
Right now, we've got the ball, the South Atlantic League signed ball by Tyler Beattie, which is a one-of-a-kind item.
One of one.
One of one, yes. We have the BP jacket.
BP jacket, sweet.
We have the cleats. And the, what was the last one?
We got a glove. We got an old glove as well.
An old glove.
So for all four of them, we're at right around $50 a piece right now. So started at $5.
Yeah, scroll back up in the comments and look to see what the last bid was on for each item.
At about $50. Money goes to my More Than Me Foundation, giving back to the community.
Boom.
In Nashville, Tennessee.
Let's see. Tyler Beattie, do you know Coach Holiday... From y'all's time at Vanderbilt. He dropped y'all's on. This Nick dropped y'all's.
Yes, Nick. He was there for my freshman year before he went to Oklahoma State. What is the most important thing he taught me? So he was a hitting coach, so for the most part we didn't interact too much. But he was a guy who always had fun. He had fun coaching. He had fun playing when he played, and he always advised us and taught us to have fun when we played. So that's something I carried with me for sure.
Oh, my gosh, yeah. So... Who else joined the chat when... No. Let's see. What do we got? We all good?
Yeah, you're good. You have 50 people reacting right now.
50 people. Thank you, guys. Thank you for liking, loving this, laughing at this video. Don't cry or be angry about this video, though. Looking at all the different ways you can react on Facebook, just like there's three ways that you can react that we'd like really appreciate. The other one's like not so much. But sharing it, would be ideal. That means so much. What size are the cleats? I need a new pair.
For my church league softball.
Oh my gosh.
Billy, you've been pretty interactive. I'm going to have to, no matter what comes down to tonight, Billy, you're going to win a signed baseball. May not be the Sal League baseball, but you're getting a signed baseball.
Oh my gosh.
And the cleats are size 12. Could be size 12 and a half. One of those two.
Oh my gosh. Would you rather give up baseball for a season or listen to Nickelback every day for the rest of your life?
I'd rather listen to Nickelback every day for the rest of my life. People don't give Nickelback enough credit. I mean, don't lie to yourself. You were jamming a Nickelback once upon a time.
Look at this photograph. Every time it makes me laugh.
Yeah, so I would probably listen to that song once a day.
Yeah. Ty Kelly, friend of the show.
Yes.
He's in a bunch of the sketches. Hates Nickelback and Creed, so
yeah,
plenty of people. I think that's maybe where that comment is coming from.
Yeah, for sure.
I know every lyric she says. Oh, that's Emily. What up, Em? Do we miss any comments? Best road clubby story.
Best road clubby story. I don't really have one off the top of my head. There have been some really good ones, though, and some really bad ones.
In San Jose, we don't have road clubbies. That happened. Remember that? So it's like a whole year of just having a road clubby.
You're right.
But everywhere else, you do.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to think.
Interesting, yeah.
There are some... I think we had this one kid in Charleston this year. He was like 18 years old.
Yeah.
Unreal. Like one of the best clubbies I've ever
That's
had.
Awesome.
Yeah. He's just like a prodigy. It was like, dude, like, what are you doing? He's like, I'm going off to college next year. It's like, what?
Yeah.
Dude, you are unreal at your job. Yeah. I don't remember his name.
We had a situation one time last year. We were playing in Bowie, Maryland. So not the best place in the world. And spread is usually like, usually have a guy who like caters a meal. Has like fruit and vegetables and like little pickings for before the game. This guy didn't have hardly anything. He had bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And you know, that's all I need, really. But then we looked at the date on the bread and it was expired bread, a little mold on there. So situation where we just had to hit up Chick-fil-A and substitute that. That's a tough one.
Oh, hate to see that happen. Why is it that whenever someone goes to make fun of Nickelback, that's always the song they sing? Is it because no one remembers any other songs? What is another song? I feel like Hoobastank should get more crap, right? Shouldn't Hoobastank get more crap than Nickelback?
I agree.
Typical Orioles and Bowie. Ew. Is Bochy intimidating at all?
I think at first a little bit. He's a big dude and he's just got this like greatness to him. Like he's one of the best. He's definitely a Hall of Fame manager. So like when you're around him, you're like, man, this guy has done a lot in the game. So he's a little intimidating.
So he lives in San Diego County.
Yep.
In the off season. And all my San Diego friends hit me up whenever they see him around. They're like, hey, like, I saw your coach. And I'm like, oh, that's not my manager. Like, that's, like, the big league manager. And they're like, you don't know him? And I'm like, no, I've never met him. And they're like, wait, so are you with the Giants? And I'm like, and then I have to explain the whole minor league baseball thing. They're like, so when are you going pro? And I'm like, well, I am pro. And then it's like, yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's tough to explain.
Yeah. That should be a video.
Just bear with us.
That should be a video. Miss some other clubhouse DJs other than Crawford.
We got Morse does it a little bit. That's really it. Craw just dominates. Panic has done it a little bit. Denard Span, Jimmy Rollins. Those guys are pretty cool. What do we got from
who are you picking to win The Bachelor?
That's from my guy, my James. Main guy, pitching the GOAT. Let's see. Who am I picking up with The Bachelor? From day one, I had Corinne. That was really a gunshot decision. It turned out I don't like her too much, but she's still in it. Is she still in it?
I stopped watching after like 2 weeks ago. Yeah. I didn't take it anymore.
So she definitely makes me
watch.
She's
like the Olivia of...
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm with you. I'm not going to stick with her. I don't want her to win. But she was the one I picked. Who do you got, Jamie? Who do you got?
Are we still rolling on that?
Is that still rolling?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
How would I know? It just says
recording. It says recording on it.
Yeah,
cool.
REC.
Slow and tri-tip sandwiches are on me. Wait, what's the tri-tip sandwich place? What do we got?
No. Korean.
Yeah. Okay. So in the slow, the tri-tip sandwiches, what place is that? I have to drive through slow to get. I actually stopped for a tri-tip sandwich there. What's the place called? I can't remember. One of my friends told me to stop there because I went to school there. And it's, I can't remember. If you put it in the comments, let me know. No, not Hoobas Egg. The reason is you. Yeah. House Cereal. Am I reading that right? House Cereal? Like, House Serious?
House Serious. For what? About
Westworld or Game of Thrones? Do you watch either?
I don't. I'm sorry.
You don't have to apologize because you don't watch a show. It's all right.
I'm not much of a TV guy.
I want to start Westworld. We just like it's hard. Like during the season, I will probably crush a bunch of shows on bus rides.
For sure.
But right now, I'm busy doing stuff like this. And but for me, it's Game of Thrones. I want to watch Westworld. That's in the queue.
Yep.
That's my sister in the comments saying that we look very similar.
Cool. That's a compliment to me. I appreciate that.
Old San Luis Barbecue is the best. I feel like it wasn't that place. It was. I can't remember. Watch Stranger Things.
Yes.
Yeah. Stranger Things. Let's talk about Stranger Things a little bit. Wait. Have you caught up? Are you done watching it?
I'm done with the first season, right? We're just
my gosh. Wait, no, we can't spoil anything for people. We didn't put spoiler tags
on this. I won't spoil anything, but I have a great story. Can I share
it? Yeah.
Okay, so Allie and I, my fiance, watched the first couple episodes one night. And after a game, so it was like 10, 11 o'clock at night. And for anyone who's watched it, you know, it's like, at first you're like, what the heck's going on? There's this other dimension. That's not much of a spoiler. It is, actually.
It's the... not right side up, but
yes. So the other dimension, because I need to tell you it because of the story. So we're watching and we're like, man, this show's great. We can't wait to watch it, but we need to go to bed. So we go to bed. Fast forward, it's like 3 a.m. I'm like sound asleep, deep REM cycle. I'm like middle of deep REM, and all of a sudden I get woken up to Allie like screaming bloody murder, like top of her lungs. Like I'm freaking out. I start screaming too. She doesn't come to. She's still screaming. I start crying. I'm like, oh my god. It's pitch black in the room. Did someone come in? Is someone grabbing her? What's going on? I'm freaking out. I finally, like, get her to come to and wake up. And I'm like, it's me. Like, are you okay? She's like, oh, my gosh. Yes, I thought I was in the other dimension of Stranger Things. And I couldn't get out, and I was screaming for you. And anyways, I couldn't sleep for the rest of the night. I laid awake. My heart was pounding.
Who's your favorite character in that?
It's tough to knock her with Barb. I love Barb. She got killed off way too soon.
Whoa, spoilers.
She is still around. She's great. 11, because it's my favorite number, and also because she's a boss.
And those Eggo waffles.
The Eggo waffles, like, we relate so much. Yeah. And she can rap. Have you guys seen her rap? 11. Check her
out.
Really? She raps. She does. I didn't know that.
I just posted this. So I just posted this video over to the current and retired MLB and MILB players group on Facebook. So hopefully we get some of those guys in here. That would be cool. I should have thought of that earlier. But
we're approaching an hour in. This is phenomenal. We've had 1,000 views, I think.
Is it really?
We've
Oh my gosh. We're at 1,000 views.
Almost over 250
people
comments.
Watching right now. Guys, thank you so much for sharing this. Everything like that. Liking it. Loving it.
Yes.
Laughing at it. Let's see. Let me go back to some comments because I missed them. I watched Stranger Things. My son's attending Vanderbilt baseball camp this summer. How is it playing for Coach Corbin?
Coach Corbin, he's I'm a little biased, but he's the best coach in the country. He's so fun to be around. You'll love that camp. We were. I think some of the guys will be at it in the summer. Some of the players will be there. It's a lot of fun. Coach Corbin's the best. Well, tell him I say hello when you see it when you get there and enjoy it.
For reals though, lunch on me next time you cruise through. Bring Tyler and Chase. probably thinking about Firestone.
Firestone? What's Firestone?
I think you were saying the
restaurant. Oh, yeah. Yes, yes. Okay, yeah. That sounds right. Favorite NFL and NBA teams?
Patriots, Celtics for me.
Yes, same. It's, I mean,
I like the Warriors, too. I've been a bandwagon fan of the Warriors. I love Steph Curry, what he stands for, how he plays.
I had to be living with Ty Kelly and Matt Lujan. I had to be a Warriors fan living in that apartment because they are diehard Warriors fans. That's awesome. It looks like we have some former and current MLB players coming in to watch the live stream now.
Cool.
Let's see. Do you believe in ghosts or hauntings while on the road? No, but I believe in something's coming after us on this roof.
On this roof.
That was scary. Something was up there, right? Like, I'm not just hearing things.
No, there's a noise, for sure.
But like an animal, right?
Right. You're going to have to charge rent.
It's squatting.
Share in the building.
Yeah.
Are we freeze or are we good?
Are we frozen?
You're not frozen on this.
Okay, so we must have...
But there was a delay in comments coming in, so maybe that's the
number. Because we're frozen on here, so...
You're not frozen.
We're not frozen. Okay. No. Maybe they're just...
Ask them if you're frozen.
Let me look. Are we frozen? Let it go. Let it go.
What a voice.
Hey, incredible. Stop it. Do you guys like to read during the season? What's your favorite reading material? That comes from Sarah. If we're not frozen. Let me close this and see if it's on my end.
Somebody just came in. Not frozen. No, not frozen.
Not frozen. Okay, cool.
Okay, favorite what? Reading material?
Yeah, favorite reading material.
Oh. I love a good C.S. Lewis kind of guy.
We know you're not frozen.
Not frozen. Yeah. But I'm frozen on my iPad. That's the only issue. So I am going to refresh the comments right now on the iPad. So let me go into the live feed. Look at this. Look how sad we look in the thumbnail.
That's actually hilarious.
I can't scroll up to read the other comments.
Do you want me to read you?
No, that's okay. We have some. I can scroll back far.
Update on the bids.
Can you update us?
So nobody's bid has placed a bid since it's been standstill. $50 for each of the four items.
Yeah, right.
Sal League Baseball.
I think we hit 60 for something.
60 for the jacket.
Yeah, it was 60 for the jacket.
The BP jacket. But we got a Sal League Baseball, one of one. Nobody has one. We got cleats and an old glove.
Who's your pick, NCAA men's college basketball?
I'm going to go with... this is tough.
Ray Allen played for UConn.
I love UConn, man. Is UConn...
I don't know.
Admittedly, I haven't watched much college basketball.
Boys is not good this year.
Yeah. Really? Obviously, the girls' team is unreal. I'm going to go with... What's that team?
I'm at $70 for the cleats.
We had two people at 70.
70? Yeah. Someone did 70. Yeah, if you guys can scroll back in the comments and look, that would be awesome. Your dad says UCLA.
Oh, I like that pick. Mm-hmm. Big Walt, he's got this intuition that's tough to argue with. He's been right on a lot of things in his life. So, UCLA, if you're a gambler, go to Vegas, place your bids. Big Walt, he usually knows something.
$60 for the glove.
Okay.
I'm at $60 for the jacket. And then $70 for the cleats. So $60 for the jacket, $70 for the cleats, $60 for the glove. And what was the ball at? I think the South Atlantic League signed baseball. Like, he didn't even play in the South Atlantic League. That is a one-of-a-kind item. You cannot get anywhere else.
I agree.
Maybe they're like, well, he didn't play in the South Atlantic League. I don't want to do it. But that's why it's awesome. No one else has that.
Correct.
But we'll have to, like, use this video as proof that it is you because someone will look it up. Like, right? Often an appraiser, right? Yeah. Don't they, like, appraise the... Or no, they authenticate it.
Yep.
So we have to make sure that we somehow authenticate that ball. Okay, yeah. Right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's going to be important for
absolutely. We'll put a sticker on there.
What's for sale? So, South Atlantic League signed baseball, one of a kind, a glove, BP jacket, cleats. All going towards charity.
Yes.
To the...
The More Than Me Foundation.
More Than Me Foundation. How many times did mom call you while you were driving to spring training? Okay, my mom called me twice, I think. Once to just check in on me, and then another time, it was, like, really sweet. My mom was like, hey, Matthew, I'm just, like, I just want to say I'm really proud of you.
Aww.
Right?
That's really
like,
sweet.
Yeah. It was so nice. She was just like, I just want to say I'm really proud of you. You know, you just work so hard. And I was like, Mom, stop. I'm just a goofball.
This has just inspired me to be appreciative of this guy right here. you see the game of baseball, any sports, and guys, you know, they stay in their lane. They just want to kind of go through the motions and just kind of be that one-sided baseball player, which isn't a bad thing. You know, guys put a lot of work into being a baseball player. But this guy cares about things off the field. He cares about personal brand. This guy is changing the world. He's changing the culture of baseball. He is inspiring. I'm proud of him, for sure. And I'm proud of all you other baseball players.
So I talked about this in my last live stream, about the importance of not defining yourself as a baseball player, because the reason why athletes run into trouble with that is that when you define yourself as an athlete, that you can't define yourself with a title, because eventually that gets taken away from you.
Exactly.
Eventually everyone is going to be done playing. So when you say I'm a baseball player, that title gets taken away. Are we frozen?
No, I'm just...
Okay. That title gets taken away from you. So it's important to find yourself with an attribute. So for me, I like to think of myself as an entertainer, right? Because no matter what, I can entertain people in any capacity, right? So when I'm out on the field, I want to play as hard as I can. I want to be entertaining, right? So I can still be a baseball player, but because what happens is athletes they go through identity crisis when they're done playing.
Right.
Because what they've been defining themselves for so long as a baseball player that they have nothing left to fall back on. So I think it's really important to teach your kids to not define themselves. And that's really hard, because that's how people treat us too, and that's how people look at us, and that we are baseball players. But baseball players, athletes are so much more than that. They have so many more interests, and if you want to speak to that in any regard, I'm sure people would want to hear.
Yeah, very well said. I certainly experienced that going through college, where 100% baseball was my identity, and it becomes easy to make it your identity, because you know you have so much success when growing up, and you just start to see that when you have that success, you kind of have this happiness that like goes along with that success. Not until you kind of have that adversity where you face those failures, where like you start to kind of see that your mood really goes with the game. And that can affect a lot of people in your relationships, your family, and outside of the game, that you really start to kind of take a step back and see where your true identity is. And understanding that baseball, it provides us a platform to, you know, impact other people's lives. We can play the game because we love it and we want to win. At the end of the day, we'll only play baseball for probably this much of our life, and we have this much more that we need to be accountable for. And so, just like he said, man, like, for me, I try to, I'm centered in my faith. So for me, no matter if it's a good day on the ball field or a bad day, I'll be frustrated if it's a bad day, because I'm a competitor, and so is he, and so is everyone else. And I think, you know, we try to be real. We don't want to try to mask our emotions and our feelings. But at the same time, we want to be aware that, you know, when we're hanging out with our family, we need to be, you know, just good humans. We need to just be, we need to be a son. We need to be a fiance. We need to be a brother, and not just a grumpy baseball player. Sometimes try to separate the two, which is tough, but something that you will learn through experiences.
Yeah, that was amazing. So let's see. Jake Smith joined. Jake Smith. Wow. Jake. Great to have you here with Homeless Minor League Live. And this is what I'm talking about. This is why I think Homeless Minor League Live is so great, because fans and baseball players are all part of this chat that we're having. It's so cool.
Bringing everyone together.
Which
over everything. No, it's true.
Fucking donuts, kid.
Honestly, blown a hole, man. Munchins. Well.
Yeah. Munchins.
Oh, you can eat Munchins on those.
Yeah,
just
one
blazed.
Of those, one of the pails that you grab.
Yes.
Dunkin' Donuts.
Oh, those are
oh,
the best.
Man. Let's see. Wait, your dad just sent a question mark, so.
Oh, because he was wondering.
What did he say?
He said, what's a good name for a new roast beef sandwich place?
Oh.
One Billy Grease roast beef. Roast beef place. I'm going to have to go with,
It has to be a play on beef, right?
Yep.
Roast, and then,
Oh,
I don't know. That's hard.
How about homeless minor leaguers roast beef shack? the HML.
HML. RVA or Scottsdale? RVA?
Oh, Richmond.
Yep.
It's Richmond.
Or Scottsdale? Ooh. That might be a loaded question.
Yeah. That's a trap. That's a trap
I'm
question.
I'm going Richmond, Virginia.
Yeah. That's the trap questions, man. I got that host family one earlier in the live stream. That was tough.
I'm going to take my switch off. I'm sweating.
Yeah. See, I'm sweating right now. Let's see. No, quick, get back in. People are going to leave.
I'm back. Hello,
who switches roles better? Matt is a pitcher. You as a hitter, obviously.
I don't know, man. You've got a cannon.
No. He practices. I don't practice.
That's
he
a tough one. Yeah, that's tough.
Jake.
The Periscope ended.
Periscope ended? Okay, that's fine.
Is that
okay? Yeah, it's fine. Just, you can tweet the link out.
To the Periscope?
Just to Twitter. Let's see. Nicole, what's going on? She's a coach at Harvard softball.
Ooh, I'll have it.
Great words from both of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
For both. What's your workout routine like? We kind of answered this earlier in the live stream, right?
Yeah, so for the off season, for both of us, it's going to be a lot more weight, a lot more reps, and
a lot more intense.
Intense, yeah. So
yeah,
probably 4 or 5 days a week in the off season.
Yeah. Glad to hear you're grounded. Let's see, teaching my son's high school. It's overwhelming. Yeah. Yeah, that's when you're talking to kids about sports, it's about the experience and not about being a baseball player. I think that's important.
Johnny Mags is here. Shout out to Johnny Mags. He's a flamethrower playing with the Mets.
Oh.
Look, him and my dad, they got that connection.
Oh my gosh.
We got consistently 50
nice.
People watching. This is awesome.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm not seeing any more comments. Are there more comments popping up here?
After
what's
John.
Your favorite dog breed?
Favorite dog? Oh, gosh.
I don't know.
Oh, that's
hard. Golden Retriever.
Yeah.
I love little puppies, so whatever ones those are. I've never had a dog. It's tough to have one in our career.
Yeah, it's really hard.
Because we travel so much and we're not home.
Yeah, we don't get to.
Many hours of the day.
Yeah, we don't get some of those nice luxuries. I'm still frozen on here, so I'm gonna try closing the app and refreshing.
You're live here.
Okay, could you read one of the questions for me, please?
You are stranded on an island, and you get one Ty Bede or Ty Kelly.
do I get Tyler Beede or Ty Kelly? Well, who's gonna be more resourceful, right?
I don't know.
You might. Yeah, I trust your New England, but the thing is, then like your New England mind is going to be the same as mine.
That's true,
right? We know how to survive in cold weather.
Yeah,
but neither of us know how to survive in a drought, right? So like, and he's dealt with that living in California. That's what I'm saying. So like, I might say him just because he knows how to deal with not having a lot of water.
That's totally fine.
Dude, are you like cool with that? Because I think that like I totally rationalized that in my head.
I'm totally
cool
with that.
All right.
I'm totally cool with that. I felt like what all I would bring to the table is keeping us sane with freestyles, keeping us sharp, and playing catch with coconuts, maybe. Yeah. Throwing a couple coconuts. That's pretty much all I'd
swimming.
Bring to
a lot of swimming.
Oh, tons.
They're all good dogs.
John Gorman joining. Wow.
Johnny Gorman from Boston. College Kid.
Wow.
Oh my gosh. Doctor. Yes. 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 I had to refresh. We had to refresh too. What was it like having Willie Mays in the clubhouse? Anyone get starstruck or just normal?
Yeah, that's pretty easy to be starstruck. I know that he's come over and talked to you guys, right?
Yeah, yeah. So he just tells the funniest stories, man, when he's there.
Willie funny. Mays,
like,
he's, man.
Someone asked him about a slump. Like, what was the worst slump you went in? And, like, what did you do to get out of it? He goes, well, you know, I went 1-for-4 one time. And that was like, yeah. And, like, he's dead serious. Like, he is the best baseball player of all time.
That is Willie Mays for you. He's got great stories. Loves talking about his playing days. And he's in there every day. He still comes in every day. He's sharp. He's, like, upper 90s, I want to say. He's, like, 90.
Broadcast interrupted, maybe. What just happened on there?
So,
nothing. You just got a comment.
Someone, like, message me or something like that?
Nope. It just says, best prank done in the clubhouse. I don't know. Did you get that?
I'm still seeing broadcast interrupted. I'm sorry, you guys. Stay with us. Stay with us. Technical difficulties here. Hey, for the first live stream, I think we're doing pretty good.
Oh, absolutely.
It doesn't say anything.
Let me go over to the video. I don't know. That's us right there. All right. Would you consider returning to your high schools to speak to aspiring athletes / running a clinic? Definitely to speak to them. I don't know about running a clinic, but definitely going and speaking, doing a speaking engagement there. And probably even talking about what we just talked about.
Yeah, absolutely.
With, you know, defining yourself differently. I think that would be something that I would talk about. Do you miss real clam chowder? That's from Patrick.
Patrick Hoy. Yeah, absolutely. We had a chef who was from New England actually cook us some in camp not too long ago, and it was phenomenal, but still not quite the same. Old Patrick Hoy.
Yeah, clam chowder kid. Lobster, I'd say, is one that I... So I used to pull up lobster traps with my uncle.
Really?
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Yeah, just that. Pulling them up right on the boat.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it was really cool. I have to go, but I want to say thank you for taking time to live stream. Yes! Thank you. But you're on an island, so there's water. Yeah, but it's salt water, so I don't know what to do with that. Best prank done in the clubhouse? I don't know any good clubhouse pranks.
Clubhouse prank. I heard one time there was a player who was like a avid hunter, and he brought in a live chicken and put it in one of the players' cup, like, his locker has like a little cubby hole, and he put it in there.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I was there for that.
You were there for that?
I was there for that, yeah.
So you experienced this. I didn't. I've heard about this one.
Yeah. Yeah, that was actually on social media, wasn't it?
I'm not sure.
Yes. But... Yeah, yeah. No, because it was on SB Nation, I'm pretty sure.
Really?
Yeah, it was. That's awesome. It was, yeah. It was, so you guys can check it out. Chicken Clubhouse. Just Google it.
Phenomenal.
I just don't want to say who it is because I can't remember if it was posted or not. But I do. Correct. I'm pretty sure. How does it feel to have an opportunity to compete against guys like Joey Votto and other players that you've probably watched while growing up?
Really cool. Yeah. I faced Votto yesterday, and, it's really cool. You know, I think after having a year of, consistency and success allowed me to be like convicted in my stuff. So like confident that I could get those guys out. And so facing him yesterday, for me, I didn't try to treat it like it was anything else. I just tried to make quality pitches, and if you make good pitches, I feel like you can get most all hitters out. So try not to overthink it too much. It's really cool and something that I won't take for granted, and it's something that's really fun.
That's dead? Yeah. That's fine.
Okay.
Who's the better bowler? I don't know. So San Jose, when we have the bowling event,
yep.
The beer bowler.
Yeah.
I got to wear the crown first, strike, first try. So I was the hero that night.
That
I was
is
the
him.
Hero. That's just my bowling moment that I remember. I'm not a good bowler, but for that moment I was.
He takes the cake.
Mays is 86, I think.
I was way off. I said 98. So that's, yep, totally wrong.
Let's see. In a movie about Giants 2017 spring training... Who is cast as Matt Parray and Tyler Beattie and Bumgarner? All right, so who plays you? Allie could play herself in this.
Allie's going to play herself.
So if Allie's playing herself, she would want Eric Decker to play me. who plays you? I'm going to go with...
Okay, go ahead. No, you go. You go.
Thinking like Matt Damon.
I get Christian Bale.
Christian Bale.
With the, when I slick my hair back like American Psycho. Yes.
I
also get Garrett Hedlund, the guy from Tron.
Yeah.
The guy from Tron.
That's a great one, too.
And who's Bumgarner?
Bumgarner, we're going to have to go with Tom Hardy with a beard.
Yeah,
that's actually like menacing. Yeah,
like
big.
Pretty intimidating every day, every second.
If you guys could go back and do something different, what would it be?
Oh, all the stupid things I've done, for sure. Do those different. But seriously, if I go back and do something different. I would want to meet Allie when she was a little girl, because like she was the cutest little girl, so... I would definitely
you
move
guys
to Texas.
Just both of you as two little kids.
Yes.
And then it would have like started then.
Yes.
Instead. Oh,
for sure.
That's gonna win in the comments right there. That's winning. Do you like guacamole?
You know what? That's funny you asked that. I used to like love guacamole. Huge beginning of the off season, crushed it. I think I overdid it. I got burnt out on guacamole, so don't like it right now.
It's out. You know what?
How about you?
I just had it today, so it's in for me. But it's in.
I love avocados.
It could be out. It's easy to just say no to guac for me. Foosball or air hockey? 1, 2, 3.
Foosball.
Air hockey. What? Oh man, we should do some more and or
rock paper scissors.
Right now,
best of three.
Rock, paper, scissors. Wait, are we doing the shoot?
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Okay, ready. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Ah!
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Ah!
It's closed!
Ah! Absolutely crushed.
Matt Damon, beat me to it. Yeah. Joe Hastings, Coach Hastings, welcome to Homeless Minor Leaguer Live. He was one of my coaches at BC.
Hastings?
You guys made me miss the clubhouse. Thank you for this. Oh, see, this is what I'm talking about, dude. This is why I love this show. This is why this show is going to be awesome, because we have fans and baseball players joining us all together. That's why it's awesome. I'm off to make dinner. Oh, of course. Who has influenced you the most and how? Hold on. Wait, real quick before. Guys, get your bids in. Last chance for the live auction. We have the baseball live baseball. No, it's a signed South Atlantic League baseball.
I'll sign it right here in front
right,
of you guys.
Right that's now. Yeah, we gotta find a pearl. We gotta find a pearl. Hold on.
Here.
That one's not a pearl. That one's dirty.
I got it.
You got a pearl?
This is good.
This is a pearl. This is a South Atlantic League baseball right there. Let's make sure it focuses. Are we focused? I shouldn't have done that. I shouldn't have gone that close. That was a bad idea.
You're fine.
Maybe we're out of focus right now. Good? That's fine.
Yeah, you can see it.
Okay, South Atlantic League baseball. Right there.
Let's sweet spot this puppy.
You're going to sweet spot it. Tyler Beattie never played in the South Atlantic League. That's why this is a one-of-a-kind item. Okay, so we've got the ball. I can't remember what the ball's at, but we have... It looks like we have $70 for the glove.
Yep.
$60 for the BP top. $70 for the cleats.
Correct.
$60 or $70 for the cleats. You have to scroll back in the comments to read it. And this is now sweet spotted. South Atlantic League ball. One of a kind item.
Authenticated. Here we go.
Authenticated right on video. Boom. 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 Okay. Justin Thomas says, Beattie!
Justin Thomas, my man, JT. Sweet swinging lefty as well. Stud.
Guys, just so you know, this is going to be an every week thing. We're going to have a new guest on every single week, every Monday at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, at least until the season starts. Then we're probably going to obviously going to push it earlier so I can do this on the road. You were in high school when I was playing in Portland. Your mom's house was great to hang out at. Dude,
Andrew Pinckney, you are the man. Dude, I remember, these were the guys that I had my first minor league experiences with.
That's awesome.
Because they were, you know, hanging out at the house. I love this. Can you strike your dad out in this, in his day on three pitches?
Oh, in his prime? That's a battle. Three pitches? Nope. I would love to throw just three heaters right by him.
I think it's a question. Who has influenced you the most now?
I got to go with my dad for sure. I think that's a given. But not just because he's my dad. He played baseball, so he's just so knowledgeable within the game. But even off the field, just always is so wise. So he knows so much about life.
Let's see. White or orange queso? One, two, three. Orange. What?
What is orange queso?
Orange, it's just like the color. Orange, I always think of like orange being like the cheap stuff. Like that's where you get at the ballpark.
On your nachos?
But yeah, but white. Like the white, you change it to white now?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, white is
but
like.
But I like being the opposite of you because it's really funny.
You know what would be fun next time is to have a live audience during this too. Wouldn't that be cool?
That would be. I wonder who would come. My dad? when our family's coming. Yeah. Definitely.
Who did we miss here? $80 for the glove. Wow. Okay. Lost you completely. What does that mean?
What's up, Sarah?
Are we still live?
You're live.
Okay. You already said what's up, Sarah?
Yep.
Okay, cool. I guess this is a good place to end it. All right.
Oh, you just got a hire for the glove.
Yeah, $80 for the glove?
No, $85.
Oh, wow.
Taylor Santa.
Gosh, I feel like we should wait. Okay, let's wait until 1 hour 30 minutes.
You got 3.5 minutes.
Yeah.
Until we close up shop. Let us know if there's any final questions, but get your bids in. That's probably most important at this point. If you're still watching and you made a bid, that's what's going to pretty much be the final.
Yeah, so we're going to go through the comments. We're going to go through the comments. Well, that's Mike Connolly. Shout out to Mike Connolly, who just got engaged.
Yes.
Popping up on my Facebook.
That's awesome. On Camelback, right?
Yeah, they got engaged on Camelback. Oh,
that's a beautiful ring.
Yeah, let me make sure it's something I can share. Yeah. Mike Connolly just got engaged.
Woo!
Congratulations. Well, now I remember what I was doing. I was going back to this because I have to see. What we got going on here?
Baseball or anything?
I didn't even know. Oh my gosh. Let's see here. South Atlantic League Baseball. Can you get Tyler's for a guest appearance next week? What Tyler's? Which Tyler's besides you?
I know Mr. Quintanamo. I would love to be back on. It would be an honor to be back on the show for another guest appearance. Maybe. We'll see.
Yeah, for sure.
Tyler's dad.
Where? Gotcha.
When he's in town. Yeah. For sure.
That'd be fun.
Scheme something up.
Club sandwich or BLT? Wait, I gotta think of what a... Okay, I think I know what a club sandwich is. That's like ham and turkey, right? That's a ham and turkey one?
Yeah.
All right, ready? One... 2, 3.
BLT.
You knew I was going. You knew it because I asked. That's not fair. You knew. You just wanted to be different. What's the other comments on here? Do we have any bids on the...
This is awesome.
Not since the 85.
Okay, so far, Taylor Santos winning the glove?
Yep, the glove at 85. We have the BP top at, I want to say it was 70.
70.
The ball, which hasn't been bid on once, has it? I feel like it was way earlier.
I don't remember.
The ball has been bid on earlier in the... I can't remember it. I honestly want to say it was at 50.
Yep, I agree.
Yeah, I think it was at 50, and the cleats were
you got 100
for the glove.
100 for the glove. Wow.
I was about to go to bed. Can you say goodnight? Goodnight,
Alex.
Goodnight,
Alex.
That's awesome. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, thank you. All right, we have 50 seconds left to get your bid in. Yeah, ball was 50. Okay, you have 45 seconds to get your bid in. Yes, it was like 50. Okay, yes. So get your bids in really quick. I'm gonna leave the live stream.
Sign baseball right here. We got
105 for the glove. 105 for the glove. Oh my gosh!
Glove's the big hit, huh?
Oh my gosh! Wait, we missed an either or. Tacos or burritos? 1, 2, 3. Burritos. Yes! Oh my gosh! J. Cole. Oh, or Drake. This is hard.
This is for my brother.
Yeah.
It is.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
J. Cole. 2 for 10.
Yeah.
10.
So I used to be a huge Drake fan. Now, like, J. Cole, I don't know. It's tough. That one's tough. But I think J. Cole right now.
Drake is great.
Hot right now.
Tough. Not
75 for the jacket. Okay. Wow. All right. Let's see. When is the other Beatty going to be a guest?
Whenever he comes out of here. Oh, Joey. Moobs! That's his nickname. Moobs. My man. Oh, he's going to be a guest here soon when he comes up. If he wants.
Yeah, for sure.
Who would win?
Who would win in a game of Operation? Who's got this? I think you got the Stiller hand. Yeah, for sure.
No bullshit.
I think Matt.
I win?
Actually, I don't know.
1, 2, 3. You win.
You win.
Thanks for the Homeless Minor Leaguer shirt. Yeah. Guys, go check out the Homeless Minor League apparel. It's over on Redbubble.
Yes. I had to order mine.
I haven't had one yet. I haven't even gotten one myself, but I heard they are very, very comfortable.
Ray's comment. Who wins in a fight between you two?
All right, ready? One, two, three.
Me! See, next week. We're going to have a live fight.
Yes. Battle Royale. Special live stream. Okay. So I think that's going to be it, guys. Thank you. What do we got? Hold on. What just happened? Did I miss something?
Somebody asked, what are Saturdays for?
1, 2, 3. The boys.
Okay. We're going to end the live stream now. Thank you so much for joining us, Tyler Beatty.
Thank you.
For being on. We really appreciate it. And join us next week. Every Monday, Homeless Minor Leaguer Live is on Facebook Live at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Thank you guys so much for joining. And if you made it this far, you are definitely part of the Homeless Minor Legion. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys for the live stream next Monday at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.